quality legislation that has been affected both due to the constitutional and statutory constraints and erosion of conventions, values and principles. The question itself talks about quality legislation that is being affected. No second thought about it. And in this context, it is also saying that is because of two reasons. One is a structural constraints, that is because of constitutional and statutory provisions. Second, due to the degradation of conventions, values and principles. So you have to make a good beginning. After that, you have to elaborate both these issues which are affecting the quality legislation and what needs to be done that should be towards the end. Let us make a good beginning. During the previous two decades, in fact, when he is making a statement that the quality legislation is hampered, then the beginning should be to support that. Several aspects that indicate erosion of quality legislation, such as gelatining number of bills without discussion. That means passing the bills without any discussion. Number of bills are dumped and passed. Number of bills are grouped together, passed without any discussion on the last day of the session. Not referring the bills to the standing committees. As far as 16th Lok Sabha is concerned, 71% of the bills not referred to the standing committee. Not circulating the bills for public consultation. Bypassing the upper house in the name of money bills. Going as per the whips, people are not able to exercise their conscience. Are clearly visible. That means these are all indicating quality of legislation going down. Here there are both the structural reasons combined with erosion of values and principles, conventions. First, let us focus on constitutional and statutory constraints. First is the anti-defection law, system of whips. You can explain this, that is affecting the conscious judgment of the members of parliament. Second is Article 102. In fact, that says an MP is barred from holding any office of profit. The intention of the constitution framers is the legislators, that is MPs, should not be under the influence of executive. But what is happening is, office of profit is not defined in the constitution and the parliament is exempting several posts. And because of that, several MPs are getting certain positions. That means influence of the executive on the MPs. So this is another reason. Third important aspect is, there is no bar for the MPs with the criminal background entering the portals of the legislatures. But the important aspect here is, the criminal antecedents members are increasing significantly in recent times. Not only that, whatever the reason, crorepatis are becoming MPs. And that is not giving level playing field to normal persons. Second is, intellectual talent is reducing because of that. So criminality in the politics, this is the issue which the parliament should look at. And level playing field for the common man to contest, how to ensure that? So you can see these are the constitutional and statutory constraints. Second part, erosion of conventions, values, principles. You can quote any number of erosion of conventions. First is gelatining number of bills without discussion. That means parliament session, suppose if it is 21 days, 18, 19 days, they simply discuss, argue, and finally the leftover bills are passed en masse on the last day. And serving officials of the executive. If you look at the Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha secretariats, several officials from executive are there. Then how can Rajya Sabha, Lok Sabha secretariat does not come under the influence of executive? Then reduction in the oversight of parliamentary committees. Now around 70%, 80% bills are not referred to the parliamentary committee. Bills are not being circulated. Normal convention is bills are circulated for public consultation. That is missing. And upper house is bypassed by designating the bills by the presiding officer as money bill. Then debates are less. In fact, when you are having doubt about any constitutional article, you go into the constituent assembly debates to understand what is the spirit of that particular article. And such things are missing now, because there are no debates taking place. If any doubt arises with regard to particular legislation, you have no choice. You have no established thing, or you can say you cannot dig further what is the spirit of the framers of the legislation, because no debate. Executive exceeding the remit of the legislation while framing the rules. Several times executive frames the rules which goes beyond the remit of the legislation. Of course, the Committee on Subordinate Legislation is there to look into these things, but always it cannot look it. Then poor attendance several times. And both I explained. Finally, how to conclude? On some good note, on some reassuring note, you have to end. Sometimes it gives an impression that India's legislative wing is not distinct from that of the executive. A question may also be asked. India's legislative wing is not distinct from that of the executive. Explain. The onus is on the respected parliamentarians to turn the tide towards quality legislation. With that note, you can conclude. So, I made a beginning. Second, explained various points with regard to structural bottlenecks, structural constraints. This is erosion of conventions. And finally, how to end on some good note. Thank you.